From the beginning of recorded time, mankind has turned to the Bible as the greatest source of history and of prophecy. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. The scriptures of Isaiah anticipated the beginning of a new story. 2,000 years of telling and retelling have neither clouded its meaning nor tarnished its message of hope. We are privileged to present this interpretation of the greatest of stories. Witness with us a living account of the perennial miracle of Christmas, the Nativity in Bethlehem. There went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. The story of this night spread throughout the land. And soon a new star in the heavens brought wise men from the east to Jerusalem. Stories say the first of them was Melchior, king of Arabia. His gift was gold, which signified the child to be a king. The second was Balthazar, king of Ethiopia. He brought frankincense, which honored the child as a priest. And the third was Gaspar, king of Tarsus. His gift of myrrh symbolized the child's future as a great healer. And so they rode together across the desert sands until they reached Bethlehem. And the star moved across the sky, leading the way, until it stayed over the stable where the young child lay. The wise men were filled with joy upon seeing the child with Mary and Joseph. They knelt down to him and offered the gifts they had brought and worshipped him.
Yeah! He was born in an obscure village, the child of a peasant woman. He grew up in another obscure village, where he worked in a carpenter shop until he was 30. Then, for 3 years, he was an itinerant preacher. He never had a family or owned a home. He never set foot inside a big city. He never traveled 200 miles from the place he was born. He never wrote a book or held an office. He did none of the things that usually accompany greatness. While he was still a young man, the tide of popular opinion turned against him. His friends deserted him. He was turned over to his enemies and went through the mockery of a trial. He was nailed to a cross between two thieves. While he was dying, his executioners gambled for the only piece of property he had, his coat. When he was dead, he was taken down and laid in a borrowed grave. 19 centuries have come and gone, and today he is the central figure for much of the human race. All the armies that ever marched, and all the navies that ever sailed, and all the parliaments that ever sat, and all the kings that ever reigned, put together, have not affected the life of man upon this earth as powerfully as this one solitary life.
Sons of earth, born to